Now, it turns out that English is a very hard writing system to crack. So I've got four words here that are reasonably simple, but they already reveal some serious challenges that the child will face. And the first is probably the most difficult challenge, although it's rarely acknowledged, and that is one of grain size. Sounds can be represented by one, two, three, or four symbols. So we have cases like the G in games, represented by one symbol, the A in age, represented by two symbols and a space between them, I, represented by IGH, and A, represented by EIGH. So if you think about a child coming to learn to read for the first time, will they immediately appreciate that you need a variety of different grain sizes to get that mapping going? We also have the issue that the same symbols can represent different sounds. So we have the G in gained, G, the G in age, J, or the G in thigh and eight, which is effectively silent. And the reverse is also true. So we have the same sounds representing different symbols. So we have the sound in A, gained, represented by AI, A in age, represented by A space E, and A in eight, represented by EIGH. And symbols can also sometimes represent meanings, as in the ED in gained. Do learners really need to crack that code if it's so complicated? Can't learners just come to the classroom and memorize individual words? And the answer is that they cannot do that. And the reason is that that is an arbitrary learning task. And what I mean by that is that the words cut, cat, and can, they look similar, but there's no similarity in meaning. So those are entirely arbitrary visual symbols to represent those meanings. And humans are very bad at arbitrary learning. Now, there is a case in some writing systems, like Chinese, where there is quite a lot of arbitrary learning required. But full literacy in Chinese requires knowledge of only about 4,000 characters, whereas the average 20-year-old in English can recognize about 70,000 words. And we estimate that children are exposed to around 5,000 different words just in the first year of reading instruction in English. So learners do need to crack this code. And the way that we do that is by helping learners to understand the relationship between spelling and sound. So here we now have cut, cat, and can. These words look similar and they also sound similar. So this is a systematic learning task. And it's best if we can convey this explicitly. Now, a recent study in Norway, a longitudinal study, found that by the age of seven, 99% of the variation in reading comprehension was explained by a child's oral language and their ability to decode from spelling to sound. And you can see why that is. If a child's good at decoding spelling to sound, then they're able to hook into that oral language knowledge that they come to the classroom with and access the meanings of those words.